All right. Getting right into it. Seahawks. They're 0-1. Can't take that for granted. It overall says that they were an evenly matched thing. I don't know. They're kind of in decline. I'm in ascent. A lot of young talent on defense, though. So they can make mistakes, but they do have a lot of better attributes. And, you know, my team is growing. All right, let's get this. I ran into my own dude and stalled out. All right.
Number 16 on the return.
How to play this.
Atlanta.
Let's take a look at their roster. So they have that's my roster. Okay, not remarkable speed. This guy is good enough, definitely good enough. Doesn't have a super deep arm, but I don't know if you need it. They got a good fullback? What is his catch, 70? Okay, their first two wide receivers are pretty fast. And then after that, they're not very fast. I should keep that in mind. I don't know if that makes me want to do something different. All right, their third cornerback has sub 90 speed, and their first cornerback has 91 speed. So maybe I should try to look to getting the number one cornerback isolated on my, so that's Malone, isolated on either my fastest dudes or just my best dudes, and see if he, because even my best dudes are faster than that. He's pretty fast as a free safety, so that, the fact that they have really good speed at their safety positions also protects them from speed. I think that my best bet is to have long drives. If I start reaching for long big plays, then it plays into their safety's hands for the most part.
Defense, get ready.
That was some good blocking.
Thomas, the ball carrier, number 12 on the play.
So I've been meaning to make time to watch the new MCU stuff. I have really been enjoying Hawkeye, but now I need to make time to watch it because I've been playing so many video games, which is also time well spent. What is going on? Three. Over there. That's not what I expected them to do defensively, to be honest. All right, we'll keep going that way. All right, I think that guy matched up on the tight end.
No gain on the play.
All right.
Second and 10.
That was a suboptimal run after a really good one.
Clear! Clear!
Hey, let's go.
Set. Let's go, B. Let's go.
Black.
3-6. Deuces, deuces. It's showtime, baby. All day, baby. Come on.
Horns. 49.
Here I go.
Here we go.
Horns. 49. Defense, get ready. Cut.
No, that crossing across the middle stuff did not work. Nobody, the way they dropped back in coverage, did a good job of covering that. I called the wrong play too. I went to audible. Here, they're gonna blitz me quite a lot. Not over there, huh? Well, don't step out of bounds.
Makes the catch. 7 yard gain.
He could have. With a little more body control. Do I dare? This is a little premature to be this aggressive. I could easily lose the game because of this. Alright, you, Thomas.
Danny.
This could be actually good. I had to outrun my own offensive tackle with my guard there that was pulling. He was kind of slow, but he got the edge. And when he did, that was an easy first down.
First and 10. Ball on the 46-yard line.
On the 10.
Oh, yeah, so I've been loving Hawkeye. Hawkeye's a favorite character of mine. See, back before the first Avengers movie came out, I had that app, subscription service to Marvel Comics online on your phone or a tablet, and they had all their catalog of comic books. Now, I think if it's stuff that came out this year, that's different, I think, but the old stuff is all there, and I started reading the Avengers comic books. I read, like, 0 through 173. The 0th issue, I think, came out as the annual. But there's a lot of interesting stuff in there before I burned out. A lot of interesting stories. So after the Avengers first break up, so after they first form, Thor, Iron Man, Ant-Man, Wasp, Hulk is there briefly. But they discover Captain America frozen in ice, and then Captain America joins. But then they all break up. I don't know why. I forget. But then Captain America has to put together the new Avengers, and he gets former members of the League of Evil Mutants, Quicksilver and Scarlet Witch, to join. And, of course, you know, Scarlet Witch is super powerful, so she makes the team. And so does Quicksilver. And then Hawkeye. Hawkeye had fought Iron Man. People thought he was a villain. He wanted to prove that he was a hero, so he joined, and that was the whole team: Captain America, Hawkeye, Quicksilver, and Scarlet Witch. And I think that's a pretty fun team. They're definitely, like, scrappy, and they're up against cosmic threats like the Avengers usually are, and it's just four people. So I enjoyed that. And Hawkeye, in his original appearance, was a foe of Iron Man, who was a rival's arm manufacturer, wanting to prove that his trick arrows were as good as Iron Man's suit. Pretty contrived. And he wasn't really developed very well at that point. Had a cool costume and look. That was pretty much it. But over time, they added a lot of stuff, including, like, that he had a mentor that was a swordsman, who was like a valorous, rogue, dashing villain, who sometimes was also an Avenger. Because I guess when shit hit the fan, he was like one of the good guys, even though his, like, character is to be a mustache twirling rogue. Ha ha ha, this is my diamond. Hell yeah, Thomas. And so I've only gotten 2 episodes into Hawkeye, but I've been loving it. And I think the fiance that's marrying Kate mother, it's like, is that the swordsman? I wonder if he's going to be a villain. Or maybe he's secretly an ally. Maybe he is Hawkeye's mentor in this comic book universe. I don't know, in the MCU, what his relationship is. I've been curious about that. All right, number 5. I mean, there's, like, nobody on the left. And you can see there's a lot of dudes on the right. I can see that guy open easy. So he got the ball. I know there was more I could have done over on the left, but when you have an easy pass, it's good to take it.
Second and 4. Ball on the 15-yard line.
On the 10. Play hard and fast, baby. You turn it set. Out. There we go, D. Yeah.
We'll see. We will see. Yeah. That was a long drive. 4.5 minutes. That's not my longest, but that's pretty good. So after Endgame came out for the Avengers, I actually took a break from watching Marvel movies. But then I broke the seal, and now I'm, like, way in. Actually, okay, the first stuff I watched, I did watch WandaVision when it came out, and I watched, oh my god, what's happening? Is it too late to hit the timeout at that point?
Kickoff return.
Not the kickoff I intended. My daughter actually turned on WandaVision, and that first like two episodes where it's still like Bewitched or I Dream of Jeannie. And they have what they call, nowadays they call it Disney School of Acting, but it's actually a vaudeville school of acting on those shows. And my daughter loved it. And little kids love vaudeville style acting. It's very expressive. And you can see it on the Disney Channel today. So some people call it Disney School of Acting. It's a reputable and historic way of acting. I mean, it seems corny and contrived, but without electric sound amplification, that was that's how you did it, to demonstrate, to be demonstrative about your speech so people understand you, so people can get your expressions. Because, you know, people didn't have good vision. People in the audience, they had to listen closely. And my little kids eat it up too. So those first two episodes of WandaVision got her hooked. Well, the later episodes, when it got into like 80s TV, she wasn't into that. I loved the Captain America TV show. I thought that was awesome. Did a great job. Maddox making a big play. That's his first big play I can remember.
Maddox makes the interception. First and 10. Ball on the 19-yard line.
I'm really excited to see what the MCU does with the new Captain America, with Falcon Cap. Cap Falcon? I don't know what to call him, so I know which one I'm talking about. Timeout.
Timeout called by the offense.
I had to. They announced the movie, a new Captain America movie, so I can't wait to see it. I mean, they have so much going on in the MCU. It's amazing that they're able to keep it feeling like it's still somehow related to our reality. Because obviously after their events in like Endgame, everything would be so different. We have a hard time relating between the two. Hard to believe I got rid of the ball there.
The intended receiver on the play. Second and 10. Ball on the 19-yard line.
Let's go, defense. Set. Watch the hard count.
A lot of man coverage.
Jones,
so with man coverage,
1 yard gain
you
on
can
the
do
play.
Comebacks against it.
Ball on the 17-yard line.
Let me do that with Jones. Who's covering Jones? He's my best player.
Watch your eyes. 36.
Let's give Jones a chance to make a play.
Jones on the reception, gain of 6 on the play.
Go for it. Who said that? Go for it. Who said that?
Come on, we're talking about real.
It was a me, Mario.
Come on. Hey.
Set.
Let's go, beat them.
36.
It's showtime, baby.
Here I go.
Here we go. Temple.
Yeah, you see me.
Hell yeah. That was a good fourth down run. I really wasn't... I mean, Captain America was definitely my favorite comic book character as a child. I was like 12 years old, and I was like, I'm going to start collecting comic books. I walked into a comic book store, Dragon's Lair in St. Louis in Kirkwood, Missouri. And it was Captain America fighting Wolverine. And he's labeled Cap Wolf. He like turns into a werewolf. And I was like, I love werewolf movies. I'm going to buy Captain America comic books. And that is how I got into comic books. And I had to cut my running back down to make sure that wasn't intercepting. That was a naive choice. All right, so these are my normal personnel. Is no one covering my fullback? Oh, they are. Okay. Interesting, there's nobody really over there on the right-hand side. Like, I don't know what's up with that. I wonder who would get 32. Nobody got 32. I was like getting hit pretty quick.
1 yard loss on the play.
All right.
Third and goal. Ball on the 6 yard line.
Third and
goal. We're talking about Maria.
Ball on the 6 yard line.
Go make a play.
Set, go. 36. Spread. Watch the man.
You think they're in man coverage?
You got
yes.
Let's do our thing. Don't stop.
Go back.
Let's turn it up, D.
Three shoot. Deuce.
Purple. 64. All right, now.
Hey. Uh-oh. Yeah. Oh.
The pass ball's incomplete. London, the intended receiver on the play.
I think I'm going to stop going for it on fourth down now. Maybe I should. I gotta stop. Somebody stop me. Not me, though. I'm the one that put me there. Hike the ball. Touchdown over there. See, I mirrored my camera now. It's a mirror. It's a little tripped out for me to look at it for some reason. I don't know why. It's like throwing me off. But that means I can point. The touchdown was on the left-hand side. If you look at this box, I don't even know what that's called while it that hashed line moves about it. Well, let's win this game so I can go finish the Hawkeye series. I'm pretty excited about it.
The extra point attempt is good.
Did I mention Shang-Chi? I enjoyed the hell out of that movie. Dude, Kung Fu fights
is lined up for the
Cthulhu. The motivation on the father, I just loved it. I thought there was a lot of just quality writing that went into that. Made it a fun movie. It made it an emotional movie. They had like, you know how it's a joke. It's a cliche to go on and on about family. That was a bad kick return. It's a joke to talk about family, but the thing is that these movies often reference family stuff because it has easily accessible emotional triggers for people in the audience. And I think that movie did a great job of making it about family while not being a cliche about family. It certainly wasn't a family-friendly thing. And it was more sympathetic than the psychotic, egocentric father figure in like Guardians of the Galaxy 2. There's like no sympathy for Kurt Russell by the end of that film. But in this film, I thought it was great.
Ball on the 34 yard line.
Come on! Here we go, baby! Go make a play! Check.
Someone get there. Jeez. Get an interception. Come on.
Incomplete pass. Lindsay, the intended receiver.
And so I started binging more MCU, and I finally watched Black Widow, and I thought that was wonderful. Actually made me cry. Oh, man, I was like really sad that that was going to be the last Black Widow movie. But she should have gotten a trilogy. I mean, that was so good. And the character, like, the reveal regarding Taskmaster was really, like, I thought, poignant. Making her like confront victims from her past was, I mean, you can't ever make it up to somebody.
First and 10.
But at least they didn't whitewash it. They didn't just like make it never happen. Although I gotta wonder, like, that's the shittiest bomb ever. I mean, seriously, how could it not kill two people? It destroyed half a building and couldn't. Nah. Maybe the doctor had already been doing stuff at that point. Thank you, 54. Good pass deflection there. I hope he's credited with a pass defense. Son of a biatch. Wanted to be up by two touchdowns going into the second. I can still do it, but I wanted just to force a punt.
Cut.
The extra point attempt is good.
Oh, yeah, I got to finish the Eternals, too. I've watched like 2 minutes. And I wanna...
Seattle is lined up for the kickoff.
I've been playing too many video games. Back deep to but I definitely want to see the Eternals. All right, I saw the opening scene, and then my kid came running in. I had to go do other stuff. I thought it was the opening scene all the way till she's in New York City, I think, taking pictures of the billboard. And I'm definitely intrigued. You know, Thanos looked like a deviant, but he was an Eternal in the comic books. But he was an Eternal that looked weird, and they didn't know why he looked like that. I've had some time recently to think about the original, Infinity Gauntlet comic book. And in it, Thanos is often trying to woo the character Death and be like, Death, why won't you acknowledge me? Give me a sign, drop a handkerchief, wink at me. Any acknowledgement of my existence, please, lady, give it to me. I should kill half the universe such that you could love me. For the first time, reminded me, oh my God, I thought I was, oh my God, that was supposed to be a throwaway. Ha! What the fuck?
The replay official is reviewing the call.
Maybe it still is a throwaway.
The ruling on the field has been challenged.
I don't know what I'm going to see here.
The ball did not touch the ground. The player had possession, and it is an interception.
Dude, what a crappy sequence of events. What the fuck, bro? How am I going to be up by 2 touchdowns going into the second half at this rate? That's what the newspaper should say, like, Falcons implode in this. What the hell? All right.
Kickoff return 23 yards. First and 10. Ball on the 26-yard line.
Watch the play. Say, do it, baby. Watch screen.
Go. 36. Purple.
Solo.
9.
Let's go, B. Let's go. Hey, purple. Watch that screen.
19.
Let's go. Be good.
Let's go now.
Come on. Going long. Go back.
Number 16 makes the catch. The play results in a first down. First and 10. Ball on the 47-yard line.
All go special.
Lewis. Nobody. I mean, they're not even deep.
Black 19. Purple 36.
Let's go. Let's go. Let's go!
Purple, 64!
Move us, don't make a play!
Don't stop that motor! Two girls on that!
Get it, Lewis, get it, Lewis, get it, Lewis! Yeah! That's my revenge! Okay, now if I can get the ball back, I can still be up by 2 touchdowns. That only took me like 3 seconds. I don't know how long that took me. And those safeties were backpedaling, and as soon as he got next to the safety, I was like, ah. I knew he could burn him at that point. Those safeties should have been further back, basically.
Atlanta,
they called
the
kind of an up-close defense,
Burrow,
I thought.
Back to return.
All right, let's not give up the short field again.
Kickoff return 22 yards. Burrow on the return. The Seahawks will start the drive.
No more, fella.
Get off that left tackle. Come on. Ah.
Calls a timeout. Reston with the reception. First down on the play. First and 10.
I think this quarterback might scramble now and then. Spoto. I got pancake there. If he catches that, I'm going to be upset.
The pass ball's incomplete. Lindsay, the intended receiver on the play.
Let's do our thing. Let's do our thing. Play football.
Set.
Right.
There we go.
That was a catch, huh?
By the offense. Reston with the reception.
Do I believe that was a catch?
First and 10. Ball on the 48-yard line.
Get it started, get it started. We like to crack the rules. Get it up. Get it started. Get it.
Kind of arbitrarily chose to track that specific player down the field with my linebacker. And fortunately, for whatever reason, the quarterback decided to throw to him.
Here we come.
Here I go.
Back it up, baby. Temper. All on us, y'all.
Oh, that would have been a wonderful interception. That would have been a pick six.
Third and 10. Ball on the 48-yard line.
Go make a play.
Set it.
Hut. Keep it up. Let's go.
And their offensive line's doing the job. Thankfully, that guy ran the wrong direction.
3-yard gain on the play. Timeout called by the defense.
Wrong direction. Let's try a block. It's all about speed. Oh, I could have had that, I think. I think one day I'm going to block a kick. I'm going to block a punt. I've never blocked a punt before. That I can recall, and I've certainly not recorded it. There's no video of it. I blocked plenty of field goals. Not plenty. Now, I wouldn't say it's automatic, but I have a pretty good chance of doing it.
Let's go. There we go, baby. Rock and roll.
Keep the throttle down.
So he got held up there by the linebacker, slowed him down on his way up the field.
All day, baby. Come on. Dynamite.
Doesn't look like Jones is going to be well covered. I kind of think they're going to blitz me on the left.
He
didn't. And then Jones is open. Ah, catch that, man. You're my best wide receiver.
Brown on the coverage. Third and 10. Ball on the 21-yard line.
Keep it in front of
him. Go. I don't want him running outside.
Set. No more, fella. Let's go. Be fast.
I need to jump myself, I think. I've had a guy muff a punt off angling it like that. So I've always been kind of, if I'm far enough backwards, I kind of angle it down. And sometimes the ball seems to hit him in the chest and bounce off. Not a regular occurrence, but it's happened once or twice enough where I'm like, I got to try that. It's one of the things to try to increase the odds of a turnover.
Watch the ball. Here we go, baby. Watch the snap now.
Rasby, get up. No napping on the job. I want to do some sort of cover three for sure. I mean, I want to do a cover three. I don't know that this is the right cover three, but I definitely want plenty of zone across the field. Get some pressure on that man. Oh, it's too bad. At least I get one on the stat sheet. I couldn't return it, and I didn't have enough time on the clock.
We're ready to begin the third quarter of play. Atlanta will be kicking off to start the second half. Burrow back deep to return.
Oh, come on.
Kickoff return 24 yards. The Seahawks will start the drive at the 25-yard line. First and 10.
Danny.
Set.
One of us gonna make a play. Move.
Here we go.
Hey, let's go, one beat.
Green with the carry. 3-yard gain on the play. Second and 7. Ball on the 29-yard line.
We're talking about Green. Get some sweat going. Set. Nothing. They don't get nothing. Let's go.
McCoy on the reception. The result of the play is a first down. First and 10. Ball on the 36-yard line.
All day, baby. Come on. Let's go.
What's the hard count?
They ain't got nothing.
Buckley on the carry. 7-yard gain on the play. Second and 3. Ball on the 43-yard line.
You know, with all my geeking out about Marvel Universe or MCU, I actually think that Zack Snyder Justice League is maybe the best comic book movie that's come out in many years. It's just captured the epic feeling. I don't know. Endgame did such a great job, too. Endgame shocked me with its, like, opening with the mourning and I mean, people are sad, etc., etc. Steve Rogers is leading counseling sessions. People are coping with the tragedy. Everything that, instead of getting right to the action and back to the fight, I was pretty impressed with how they did that. Maddox. That's not fair. I don't know if that was really Maddox's coverage responsibility.
Seattle is lined up for the kickoff.
Big plays.
Number 16 back deep to return.
I don't know what that tackle was exactly. Some compressed air hit him in the back.
We'll start the drive at the 21-yard line. First and 10.
Let us big time.
Set. Black 19.
Hey, watch that screen. Go make a play. So we're going to take it.
I'm going.
Here we come. Don't stop that moment.
Nobody got over for that. I thought at least one linebacker would go to the left.
Gain of 2 on the play.
Let's do the track.
Second and 8. Ball on the 24-yard line.
Not today. Good shoot. Here we go, baby.
The trap is right here where 20 is supposed to run forward and hit 97 while 70 pulls.
Yard gain on the play. Third and 3. Ball on the 29-yard line.
Let's go. Be physical. All right, here we go.
Set.
Let's do our thing.
Number 4 should be open.
Hold the look. You can't stop.
That's not always an easy route because the safeties can easily interfere with it.
Black 36.
If they're in man coverage, 4 should have a pretty good route. They actually did a zone over there, and that running back was completely uncovered.
13 on the play. First and 10. Ball on the 42-yard line.
Here I come. From the start. Set. Hey, let's go. Bring it up. Hey, let's go one deep.
Go ahead, bring your safety down.
Let us big time. Let's go. Check it. Move, move.
Don't be shy.
Check
Black, 49.
Let's go, B.
We got the lead.
19. Black,
49. We're talking about Maria.
Watch out.
All right, here we go.
36.
Watch the steps now. Green shoot. Watch screen.
Jones makes the reception. Gain of 6 on the play. Second and 4. Ball on the 48-yard line.
Give my wide receivers a rest.
Back it up, baby.
Set. Purple. 19.
No, 1-1-1. Be the hammer, not the man.
This is a good formation to run this from.
Watch your eyes.
Look pretty good. Got the first down.
With the carry. 3-yard gain on the play.
That's not a first down. All right. Third and inches. Play action pass.
Let's go. Here we go, baby.
You thinking what I'm thinking?
Screen down. It's showtime, baby.
And let's lock it up, dude. Lock it up.
Oh, gosh.
Green makes the sack. 5-yard loss on the play.
Is that his dance? His little airplane dance? A jet? That's what I mean, I don't even remember his real name. Jet.
Hey, watch the screen.
Mavericks player when they won the title. Oh, come on. Lob it over him. That running back doesn't have enough awareness to do that, to like know where he's supposed to go at that point, and that's my fault for thinking he would.
They'll take over at the 47.
And I
first and 10.
See, my crown is missing. I actually have a tooth there. It's just got a lot shorter than my other teeth.
Green on the carry. Six on the play.
Gotta get it replaced.
But second and 4.
COVID backlog, so I have to wait like a week.
Let's go, man. Let's go. All right, here we go.
Anyway, I did something unconventional for me when I did the route, when I did that play combination, and I should have done it. I should have done it more conventional. I need to figure out a little better pattern, though, because obviously I have a good time reading zone and man. But there's a couple zones that actually blow up my corner routes. And if I don't get better at finding an option when that happens, I could be, you know, I'm missing out on an opportunity. So that I feel like my combination there isn't fully optimized yet, because there's a couple of defensive calls that wreck it, mostly with like a cornerback doing a dropback zone and then a safety doing a tricky zones trick me. So I'd like, yeah, that's what I drafted that guy in the first round to do. Sorry if I'm yelling. I hope I don't wake anybody. All right, get over your figures. You've got the touch. You've got the power. Oh, I should have blocked that. Didn't matter.
Kick is no good.
No good. You're no good. You're no good. You're no good.
First and 10. You're no good. 44-yard line.
One back. Stay bolted up.
Yeah, safety. I brought a safety over there.
Purple. 36.
Watch out.
From the start. Purple.
Keep moving. All right, figures. Where is their other?
Black.
Timeout. Oh my God. They didn't bring. They had no safeties.
On the offense, number 15.
Why didn't I get the ball out? Because I didn't want to do a play action pass, because they were going to blitz me so aggressively. They didn't have any safeties. They were all like going to rush, and I didn't want to do a play action pass when I wouldn't have a chance to get the ball out. Nobody bid on it. Figures is still pretty fast. Come on. Yeah. I think it's my fault he even got tackled. He kind of caught that cleaner than I realized.
First and 10. Ball on the 17-yard line.
All right,
we got 7 men in the box.
Hey, watch the screen.
Set. Pull up. We're coming to red on the 10. 10.
Goal, 19.
So, like, what's wrong with this is I never throw to three. I need to figure out something better for my outside guy so that I can get more utility out of it.
We're talking about red. Danny.
Thomas with the reception. Gain of 6 on the play. Second and 4. Ball on the 11-yard line.
All day, baby. Come on. All on us, y'all.
It's a good bet they're going to be able to answer with a score. You know?
Goal, 49.
They're kind of dense, I realize.
Here we go, baby.
So that means they might fall for my counter step and run into each other since they're all packed together like sardines. Oh, come on, Green. You totally missed that block.
The carry, no gain on the play.
This is not, this guy has a higher top speed, but his acceleration is slow. Carter.
All right, here we go.
I'm coming through, baby.
Back it up, baby.
I still wanted to leave the threat of running it, though.
Black football. 19.
Let's go, man. All right, let's go. Area. We got motion.
This would be good, pretty, yeah, do that. How is that a fumble? He's down. I am so annoyed. Instant replay? No, I meant challenge play. Was it a fumble? I couldn't tell. I mean, I meant to hit challenge play and I hit the wrong button. That is disappointing. This guy has my best carry on the team, too. No, he doesn't. That's my third down back. I think I let him down. I should have challenged his knees down. I don't know what the computer would have called that anyway. I never know. Like, I've seen the guy land out of bounds and they call him inbound, stuff like that. The sideline doesn't always line up with what the computer actually says is the boundary. There's an update actually to fix that issue. By update, I mean like a mod from fans. Man, that was
on the carry, gain of 6 on the play.
What did I sign this guy for? I give him the ball like twice. One of them is a fumble here at the goal line.
Ball on the 14 could have been
a touchdown up in this game, jerk face. Of course, I think that I should have challenged it. I missed, did the challenge. It's also on me. But I'm also, again, annoyed that I can't turn off challenges. Like, I'd rather the computer got the call right every time. Because we live in an unfair world. Can I have one little place that isn't full of your bullshit?
Ball on the 12-yard line.
You gotta have it, dude. Watch
your bullshit.
Keep the throttle down.
All on us, y'all. Stay close now. Let's go now. Let's go. Throw it down.
I almost blocked it last time. I think I have a chance. Now, what they're going to do is they shift 56 slightly out wide. I don't know why. To prevent a block, they would do that. Oh, so close. I don't know what I have to do to actually get that. All right. Thank you, defense, for getting me the ball back in a very important and tight situation.
They'll start the drive at the 46.
I feel bad for not challenging it, because now that young player has like a fumble to their name that probably shouldn't even count as a fumble. Go the other way. Go the other way. We're going to put all those linebackers over there.
First down, Falcons. First and 10.
Ooh, I meant to do 2, not 3.
Blue down. Set.
Blitz on the left.
We gotta believe it. It's our
goal.
What am I kidding? I should run it.
Let's do our thing. It's showtime, baby. Area.
called the timeout. Thomas, are they tired?
Gain of 12 on the play.
Oh, maybe they think I can kick a field goal now.
Ball on the 32-yard line.
Here I go.
No one's covering four. But there's a blitzer on the right-hand side. I didn't really need to take it out of bounds, but let you get the first down.
First and 10. Ball on the 16-yard line.
Hey, watch the screen.
Let us be tough. Set. Purple. 29.
Orange.
19.
Keep doing the wrong formation.
They ain't got nothing.
All right, let's go. Don't stop.
Snap the ball while they're all the way over there.
Timeout called by the defense.
Their linebacker was like doing this, you know, they started, they had too many guys on the left and they were coming to the right, but they kind of like got stuck in a moment of vacillation and I hiked the ball while they were in the geographic wrong spot.
Second and 2. Ball on the 8-yard
catching people out of alignment is actually a very good thing to do in football. It's a real thing, too. Not some hokey bullshit I just made up. Get in that! That guy's agility must be pretty low because he barely made that corner. One carry, 8 yards. Could you show his passing totals, please? All right, okay, I got 69 seconds. Nice. 69 seconds, and I gotta stop them from coming back into this game. Should I kick an onside kick? No. Kickoff left.
Atlanta,
that was a good drive, man. It's hard to believe I ran it like four or five times, and it was still like only 50 seconds that I had the ball. Step one.
15 yards.
I don't think they have an advantage in five man. If they go five wide receivers, I think I have an advantage.
First and 10.
Maybe their quarterback will scramble, though. That would be bad for them. Not too bad, though. Especially because they shouldn't run the ball. Bonk!
Sack makes the sack. 3-yard loss on the play.
Watch out. All go special. All go special.
Get around him.
McCoy makes the reception. 9-yard gain on the play.
Gotcha.
Mm.
All right, one more down.
Four on the play.
Turn it up now. Stay close now.
Where is that guy? Get over there. What?
Silver, 28.
That guy was well covered. I do not believe you. There were like two dudes there to deflect that pass.
The offense calls a timeout.
That's good because my guys are tired too. That's probably a catch because my guys are tired.
First and 10. Ball on the 49-yard.
They had to go out there and force that punt after my fumble. Again, five wide receiver is not an advantage because of my blitzing linebacker. They might actually be better keeping a halfback back there to protect him.
Second and 10. Ball on the 49-yard line.
Here we go, baby.
I'm coming through, baby.
Danny.
Set. Back. Yeah, Norris. Chuck Norris making a big play. He does that a lot. He's got low awareness, and he played at the University of Texas, so he has a lot to overcome. But he's got really good speed, and I just keep him around. I keep really fast dudes on my roster to play special teams. And they get a lot of tackles on special teams, even though they have like low awareness and all that. That actually does help your guys develop.
We're talking about Reed. Let's go.
And then now he's on the field. He's actually playing snaps, even though he's like 30. But I found him on the scrap heap, so to speak. That was a good win. Wasn't even a walk-off win, which I feel like I've had to endure a lot. The Falcons don't have enough talent to pull away like the Cowboys do.
The final score is Atlanta.
Even when I'm playing as the Cowboys, what's going on? I guess we did this. Finish it. Oh, that was a good game. Y'all have a good night.